Anyway, I'm the founder of Grayscale. We're a 9-year-old global ICT consulting company in the Philippines. And we operate a multilingual telesales and remote tech support call center in Clark, Pampanga. We also have a multimedia advertising and content marketing department and the technology development department. 99% of our clients are overseas corporations. So that's why we focus on the overseas market. And we're also a certified Microsoft partner. Anyway, I'll be talking about the importance of technology and how and why it matters in social enterprising and integration. No? So yeah. Let me tell you a story how technology has helped me. No? When I was 14 and my kid sister was 6 years old, no? Technology helped us survive. No? I learned how to assemble computers, I learned how to troubleshoot software, I learned how to install it, I learned how where to buy products at the cheapest possible prices, no? And sell it to the to our neighbors and the friends of our neighbors, and the entire multi-level marketing system. No? So that's how we survived, it helped us. No? And technology also helped us after I was gunned down twice and left completely blind in 2003. So back then, the companies here weren't yet ready for people with disabilities, especially completely blind people like me. So what we did then was we used technology to create our own opportunities. I reached out to major software corporations overseas. And I clinched a contract, a paid trial contract, no? And when I did my job well, I became their consultant. Because the job that I did produced significant sales margins from them. No? So, and when I started formulating sales campaigns, marketing campaigns, technology development campaigns for them, they wanted me to execute those campaigns, he said. No? So, they renewed my contract to a bigger, better, and longer B2B contract. No? They asked me to set up my own company. So, from then on, our operations grew from a workforce, no? Comprised of 4 work-at-home moms and dads, kasama si wife ko, Cherry Melencio, and me, and a couple of our friends. Apat lang kami nun. And after we clinched this contract, our workforce grew into 140 people, no? Regular employees and subcontractors combined. Overseas and local areas, meron kami contractors. I close contracts left and right just by using the phone. So what you do with social enterprising is basically when you connect it with technology, you know, you create solutions that provide unique value to the people around you, thereby maximizing human well-being. You know? That's what I do for my clients. I integrate social enterprising models into their sales and marketing campaigns and into their technology development campaigns. I improve their products for them. And I execute the sales and marketing campaigns that I formulate for them. So, and another thing is technology can help protect the environment because with technology, you reduce the consumption of materials that are produced using processes which are detrimental to the environment. No? And now, for example, Apple is also implementing a home-based arrangement with their at-home advisors. No? So here's this is an arrangement where people from all over the world can apply online. Sa Apple and become their tech support representatives. So they work from home and they don't consume gas and everything else that goes with it. No? So And as for profit generation, technology can indeed increase profits and reduce overheads. For example, with technology, you can reach wider target markets. No? You can better position your brand names across significant market segments and reduce the cost because the entire world is your, no, it's your workforce. No? Then another overlapping thing there is integration. So what is the definition of integration? My take on that is integration is providing access to everyone in majority and minority groups, no? To developmental platforms. You need to provide access to them, to developmental platforms for nurturing profits, people, and planet. That's how everything should be integrated, no? Technology, social enterprising, and the integration of everyone around you counts. No? For example, one of our clients is a software company in Canada. And what I did there, what I formulated for them was to integrate multilingual options and accessibility features into their software products. So what we did, their software products, because they consulted me and said, hey, we want to sell more of our software products. What can you do? I said, then reach wider markets. No? So what you need to do there is to provide access to people who don't speak English. No? Provide access to your software. So what we did is we integrated Japanese, we integrated French, we integrated German, Italian, Spanish, Portuguese into their software products, no? And it's so crazy. In just a year alone, it sold 3 million copies. No? And after a year, their carrier product was globally recognized as the world's best-selling Windows optimization software in 2007. So that's how powerful technology is, no? And that's how powerful social enterprising concepts are, no? When it comes to sales and marketing. And so we also integrated accessibility features, and it opened up a lot of opportunities for them as well, for sales. Because people, blind and visually impaired users like me, I've been desperately trying to find software products that can work with my screen reader and optimize my computer. Back at that time, there was none. So I told them, hey, develop this and we'll integrate these accessibility features. You open up your software product to an entire market segment, no? And that again added sales margins for them. In our multilingual call center, we support Japanese, English, German, French, Italian, Spanish, and Portuguese people here. So what we do is we go to the countries with high unemployment rates. We go to Poland and we tell the people there, hey, do you want to go to the Philippines? And the people there, 80% unemployment rate, no? So they don't have jobs. They're in their apartments freezing because it's cold there, no? They don't have jobs, it's freezing there, and you offer them a gainful employment opportunity in the Philippines, which is a tropical paradise for them. It's a no-brainer for them, no? They go. That's it. And we take them here, and then they work for us, no? And when it comes to social enterprising integration for our other departments, particularly our multimedia advertising and content marketing departments, as well as our technology development departments. So both of them work from the comforts of their home. So the people, everyone, no, with different needs, with different abilities, with different disabilities, they all work with us in these departments. No? For example, we have a lot of seniors, we have a lot of retirees, we have a lot of single mothers, single fathers, and single singles. No? And as well as persons with disabilities, different types of disabilities. No? for example, wheelchair users and blind and visually impaired people. So, and we also provide equal access to our employment systems. What we do is we don't look at the academic credentials of anyone. What we do is we have efficient processes for hiring. You know? If someone passes our hiring processes, that means the person can do the job with or without the academic credentials. That's it. That's how you integrate all these things into one cohesive and creative concept. No? That's how you use technology, social enterprising, and social integration to formulate something truly unique and truly valuable. No? That's how important technology is, and how and why it matters in social enterprising and social integration. Basically, what I learned when I was 14, I was working the streets. So basically, most of my sales experience came from the streets. What I learned there is if you light yourself on fire, people will pay to watch you burn. No? They will pay to watch you find new routes to your dreams. They will pay to watch you blaze new trails. No? They will pay to watch you reach for the stars. No? And when you're at the top of your game, because back then I was driven by poverty. I was motivated by hunger. And I was inspired by my desire of money and all the comfort that it can bring. So that's what I did, and I created something unique. And when I became completely blind, I was selling ideas. No, imagine that. No, imagine that. You pick up the phone, you call the CEO of a major corporation in Canada and say, "You pay me, I can sell more of your products." No, how does that happen? So it can. That's what I want you to do. No, especially the students here. No, create something unique. Create something of value. Don't light yourself up, no? The whole world will pay to watch you burn. And when you're at the top of your game, don't forget that you always need to constantly improve yourself, constantly grow, no? Because in my case, I built my company from scratch, and I grew it from the top down. And right now, I'm not stopping. So always remember this. So success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It's the courage to continue that counts. So make Sir Winston Churchill proud. Thank you very much.